their respective crafts, Peter Robinson and Martin Carfee.
As many there be in the year, when little Mouse Gray to the church did go, God's holy word to hear. Little Mouse Gray, he come to the church door, he spied the priest at his mass, but he had more mind of the fair women than he had of Our Lady's grace. For some of them they were clad in the green, some of them were clad in the pall. Then in come Lord Barnard's wife, she's fairest among them all. And she cast her eye on little Mouse Gray, for bright as the summer sun. And there he thought in little Mouse Gray, this lady's heart I have won. Says she, I have loved thee, little Mouse Gray, for long and many's the day. So have I loved thee, lady fair, yet never a word durst I say. She says, I have a bower in Bucklesford Bury, all daintily painted so bright. And if you went thither, thou little Mouse Gray, you'd lie in my arms all this night. Now when he heard that her little foot page, or by her foot as he ran, he says, although I am my lady's page, yet am I Lord Barnard's man. And my Lord Barnard shall know of this, whether I do sink or do swim. And ever where those bridges were broke, he has laid to his breast and he swam. Oh, sleep thou, wake thou, Lord Barnard, as thou art a man of life. For little Mouse Grave is at Bucklesford Bury, he's in bed with your own wedded wife. If this be true, you little footpage, this thing that you're telling to me, then half my lands in Bucklesford Bury freely will I give to thee. But if this be a lie, you little foot page, this thing that you're telling to me, then from the highest tree in Bucklesford Bury high hanged shall you be. So he's called to him his merry men all, by one, by two, by three. Says, this night must I to Bucklesford Bury, for never had I greater need. And he's called to him his stable boy, go saddle me my milk-white steed. And he trampled all those green mossy banks till his horse's hooves did bleed. There were some men whistled, there were some men sang, and some these words did say, whenever my Lord Barnard's horn blew, away Mouse Gray, away. Methinks I hear the thistle cock Methinks I hear the jay. Methinks I hear Lord Barnard's horn, and I would that I were away. Lie still, you little Musgrave. Come cuddle me from the cold, for it is nothing but a shepherd boy, and he's driving his sheep to the fold. Is not your horse, is not your hawk sat upon his perch? His steed eats oats and hay, and you with a fair maid in your arms, yet would you be away? With that, my Lord Barnard's at the door, and he lit upon the stone, and he's drawn out three silver keys. He has opened the doors each one, and he lifted out the green coverlet, and he lifted out the sheet. How now, you little Musgrave, do you find my lady sweet? Oh, I find her sweet, saith little Musgrave, the more it is to my pain. But I would give £300 that I ran down there on the plain. Says I have two swords in one scabbard, they cost me deep in my purse, and you shall have the best of them, and I shall have the worst. When the very first blow little Musgrave struck, he heard Lord Barnard's sword. But the very first blow Lord Barnard struck, little Musgrave struck no more. And up and spoke his lady gay on the bed whereas she lay. She says, although thou art dead, thou little Musgrave, yet for thee will I pray. And I will wish well to thy soul for as long as I have life. Yet will I not for thee, Lord Barnard, though I am thine own wedded wife. When he's cut the paps from off her breast, great pity it was to see how the drops of this lady's heart's blood cover trickling down to her deep. Oh, woe be to you, my merry men all, you were none of you born for my good. Why did you not offer for to stay my hand when you see me grown so mad? A grave, Lord Barnard cries, and they lay these two lovers in. But lay my lady on the upper hand, she was chiefest of her kin.